Om Namah Shivaya students, till now we have found that the weather is gradually improving and the narrator is determined to find the island. So let's read and find out whether he is successful. I checked and rechecked my calculations. We had lost our main compass and I was using a spare which had not been corrected for magnetic variation. I made an allowance for this and another estimate of the influence of the westerly currents which flow through this part of the Indian Ocean. About 2 p.m., I went on deck and asked Larry to steer a course of 185 degrees. If we were lucky, I told him with a conviction I did not feel, he could expect to see the island at about 5 p.m. So, the narrator rechecked his calculations. As they lost their main compass, he had to use a spare one which was not adjusted to the magnetic variations. He estimated the influence of the westerly currents which flow through that particular region of the Indian Ocean. At around 2 p.m., the narrator went on deck and he asked Larry to steer the wheel to 185 degrees. The narrator said with a conviction that he himself didn't feel that if they were fortunate, they could expect to see the island at around 5 p.m. Then with a heavy heart, I went below, climbed on my bunk and amazingly dozed off. When I woke, it was 6 p.m. and growing dark. I knew we must have missed the island, and with the sail we had left, we couldn't hope to beat back into the westerly winds. At that moment, a tousled head appeared by my bunk. "Can I have a hug?" Jonathan asked. Sue was right behind him. So the narrator was losing hope, and with a heavy heart, he went below and fell asleep. He woke up at around 6 p.m. and it was dark outside. He thought they might have missed the island and so he started worrying about how they would tackle the westerly wind as the ship wasn't capable to sail more. Right at that moment, the narrator's son, Jonathan, appeared with disarranged hair and he asked him for a hug. His daughter Sue also followed. "Why am I getting a hug now?" I asked. "Because you are the best daddy in the whole world and the best captain," my son replied. "Not today, John, I'm afraid." "Why, you must be," said Sue in a matter-of-fact voice. "You found the island." "What?" I shouted. "It's out there in front of us," they chorused, "as big as a battleship." I rushed on deck and gazed with relief at the stark outline of Isle Amsterdam. It was only a bleak piece of volcanic rock with little vegetation. The most beautiful island in the world. So, the narrator asked why he was getting a hug. His son replied that he was the best daddy in the world and also called him the best captain. The narrator replied that he was afraid. Then Sue told him that they had found the island, which was as big as a battleship. The narrator then rushed to the deck and gave a sigh of relief. They could see the complete outline of Isle Amsterdam. There was a shadowed piece of volcanic rock in front of them. It had a little vegetation. And the narrator says that it was the most beautiful island in the world. We anchored offshore for the night. And the next morning, all 28 inhabitants of the island cheered as they helped us ashore. With land under my feet again, my thoughts were full of Larry and Herbie, cheerful and optimistic under the direst stress, and of Mary, who stayed at the wheel for all those crucial hours. Most of all, I thought of a 7-year-old girl who did not want us to worry about a head injury, which subsequently took 6 minor operations to remove a recurring blood clot between skin and skull, and of a 6-year-old boy who was not afraid to die. So the narrator and all the people in the ship moored it at some distance from the shore, and the next morning all the 28 inhabitants of the Isle Amsterdam Island helped them to move on the shore of the land. As he felt the land again under his feet, he thought of his crewmen and his wife. He also thought of his 7-year-old daughter, who was very badly injured. In fact, she had to go through 6 minor operations for removing the blood clot in her head. And finally, he thought of his son, who never gave up and was not afraid to die. Students, I hope you have understood the lesson. In the next online class, we will be discussing the main points and the question answers. Thank you. Om Namah Shivaya.